Doctor.
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 Patient.
Poor Sam looks so scared right now.
What have I walked into? Where am I?
Okay.
I was having the cold sweats earlier. But what's going on?
You're all right now. You're just missing part of your leg now.
Hey. That's...
might be an improvement. By coordination.
Look,
we
okay.
can rebuild him.
You said something about the spleen. The only thing that I watched on YouTube was the amputation part. So, I mean, I just got to go with what I know.
It worked. I mean, at least you tried.
Exactly. Exactly. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to a very special edition of RCM on Tap, your 60-ish minute roundtable discussion show where we go behind the scenes of your favorite podcasts and just get to know a little bit more about the people that, you know, bring you your quality programming each and every week. And joining us this week, our patient in the fourth chair, or the fourth table, who knows, Sam from Operation Supply Drop. Welcome, Sam!
Hello!
Enjoying
How's it going, everybody?
It's going pretty good. It's going pretty good. Joining me, as always, Dr. Killer and Dr. Bio.
Dr. Killer. That's such a great name.
And, of course, RCM Legal wants us to point out that we have to remind viewers that none of us are actual medical professionals, even though we do watch a lot of YouTube videos. But Bio was technically pre-med for a while, so...
Yeah. I could use an AED, and I... used to know an override code. Anyway, that's beside the point.
I used to be certified to use the shocky paddle thing too, but then they took it away from me, so...
You were shocking way too many people.
People were just walking through the door getting shocked.
I think it was more the fact that I kept going around referring to it as the shocky paddle thing that kind of threw them on a little bit of a...
That's pretty much a technical term these days.
Yeah.
If I may say so, Baroness, I'm sure nobody who's watching right now is shocked that that happened.
Hey-o.
The look on Killer's face is what just makes this.
He's like...
That was good.
What do I do with my lives every Friday?
I know, I was just trying to think what other shocking pun I could make.
Baron doesn't believe in puns. So.
Terrible. Just terrible.
Oh, goodness. So, Sam, how are you today?
I'm doing better than I was this morning and last night. Like,
better than I was this morning. Okay. And,
like, the,
Deep.
The nausea has subsided, which is a good sign, I think. Hopefully tomorrow I can eat again. It was hard just like looking at food going, I want you, but I can't have you.
Yeah.
Hopes come right back up.
But I'm going to embarrass myself greatly right now.
Okay.
There's a tradition in my family. When you're sick and in bed, you must have the sick cup. Because you're not allowed normal drinks when you're in sick. They have to go into this cup with a straw. Even at 27.
Okay. Makes sense.
And it has whimsical kittens and frogs. Oh, you can't see. Lots of, like, woodland creatures on it.
I like it.
Yeah?
It used to be a Batman one, but Batman, he broke.
Yeah!
Wait, did a cup of Boar Bane just come around and just break its back?
Crunch!
I just...
Three times.
Three times.
I was actually thinking about this the other day because I was on the ordering site where we go to get merchandise for RivalCast, and I was going
should
a little...
have never sent her there.
Well, no. I kind of have to get the stuff for the swag bags for RivalCon, so I mean Indeed. We're kind of 6 weeks out, 6 weeks from today, as a matter
six
of fact.
6 weeks.
No
that's
pressure or
quick.
Anything.
It
there's you know, not that there's like, you know, a laundry list of things that still have to be done and people who need to be called and, you know, followed up with, and, you know, and I'm not worrying about that just yet. Not
Balls
worrying
need
about
to be
that.
Booked.
Nope,
I mean,
yeah,
fine.
No panic. No panic there. But I was thinking about it because one of the things I was looking at were the tumblers with the straw. And like somebody had told me like this great British hatred of using straws when you're an adult, because apparently only the kids use them over there. And we use them over here all the time. Like, you go into a restaurant, it's like your straw's already in your drink when they deliver it. So, I don't know, it's just one of those cultural things that makes me...
Well, that, and I think we're usually afraid of the lax job that the dishwasher probably did on those cups.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
So I mean, just like, the straw's disposable.
This hasn't been tainted by years of whatever I'm in.
That makes no sense, because then the drink, whatever inside the glass, is now touching your drink, and you're drinking the drink.
I didn't say it made sense, but that's what a lot of people think.
Also, if it was alcohol, hopefully the alcohol would burn off anything inside the glass, as long as it was potent enough. So, yeah, American beer wouldn't work.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Shots fired.
One minute.
He makes a good point, though.
No, he does.
No, that's true.
All right. So, Sam, let's talk a little bit about this very special project that Operation Supply Drop is working on this week. So, for those of you who aren't in the know, shame on you, because we've been talking about it on all of our social media stuff. It's been on the front page of RivalCastMedia.com a few times. D2D did a very special stream this past Monday, which ended up on the front page of Twitch in reference to this very special project. So why don't we talk a little bit about 8-Bit Salute?
Okay, so it is in America. It's Military Appreciation Month right now for the month of May. And so OSD has always done our main fundraising in May, because it makes sense. We also did stuff in July last year, which is when you guys came on board, and we also do Vettober, so we can do more than just one big event. This year, for May, we decided to go all out. Like last year, we just did May 16th weekend, so just 24 hours. If you can take part, fantastic. We want as many people taking part as possible. And then we realized we're kind of shooting ourselves in the foot with that, so why not do the entire month? And so, yeah, and as soon as May hit, we've had streamers of all shapes and sizes across the front page of Twitch, and just streaming. Even like if they're not on the front page, they're still streaming. And we actually, just before I joined you guys, a streamer named Austin Murray individually hit the, she's now the leaderboard, the number one spot for the most money raised, with $1,101.
Fair enough. Yeah, it was four ones, baby.
It was really interesting, because I was watching a little bit of her stream when she started earlier tonight, and it was really cool, because what she was doing was a little bit different. She was doing sketches on live sketches. And, you know, even put in there, you know, if you want to donate $15 or more, I'll do a sketch for you and send it to you. And she's really good. So
yeah, I'm
quite
actually
talented.
Yeah. I'm actually trying to hire her for some projects down the line.
There you go.
I saw her artwork. I was like, yes, you are exactly. How much money do you need? Let me throw it at you.
Take my money!
So
we are 2 weeks in, and sort of 2 weeks and a couple of days left to go, and going well. The community is growing. We lost some of our like supports towards the beginning of the year when some things went awry and people didn't agree with nothing. It was really bizarre, in my opinion. Nothing changed, yet people thought it changed. It was all just, everyone just got confused, and then it was a rebuilding year. It's a rebuilding 8-Bit Salute, but I've been loving it, and Twitch have been so supportive, and obviously all of our communities, like you guys, always been so supportive, despite the lack of our organizational skills. We powered through. We were both sitting like, haven't had an email back yet. You guys were thinking, haven't had an email back yet. It's going to happen. Turns out our emails just weren't working. We just couldn't send emails to each other, so they were just bouncing back.
I actually did figure out what that was, and it was my phone.
Oh, okay. So your phone hates me.
Yeah,
when we reset,
because we had some issues with my phone right about the time that you and I started talking about the 8-Bit Salute fundraiser, and we reset it when we put my email address back in for because it pops up on my phone. There was a typo in it, and for whatever reason, I could still get emails, but if I responded to them and then you hit reply, it wasn't going through. So, Because I thought it, okay. we eventually it figured weird, it out. Yes. Actually, Sean's the one that figured it out. He's like, did you know that there's an N in your name and that's not supposed to be there? I'm like, ooh, that could be why.
That's going to cause some issues.
Yeah. Look it up. All of our technology brought down by a typo.
I know.
That's how World War III began.
Exactly.
I just thought it was interesting it still let me send stuff from that account.
Because it would be a different set of login credentials.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's the same stuff, but you put it in twice, once for the receiving end and sending.
So, yeah, that was my
bad. There's a joke in there.
It was my bad.
Somewhere.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry.
It's actually weird. My email address changed. Like, it used to be just my first name at operationslivedrop.org, but then we made it my last name .s, operationslivedrop.org. But if you email the old one, it still comes to my email
address. There's just a forward or an alias in there somewhere that still gets it to you.
Because we panicked. We changed it, and then we realized his business cards are on the way. It's still his old email address. We're like, let's hope it works.
Yeah.
It does.
Yep. There are ways around those things.
Yeah. So how was Monday for you guys? Let's talk about, this is your second big event with us. How did it go? How did it compare to July's organization, again, which was different?
I like...
Well, we weren't competing against anyone on this one. It was just us, you know, playing. I think one of the things we thought that was kind of interesting is that there were a ton, you know, being on the front page, you get a lot of... You get a spike,
views.
Obviously, of concurrent viewers. But a lot of them weren't necessarily logged in and interacting. Because I, you know, pulled up our bot and just went, I didn't realize that not that many people were logged in when they, you know,
look at Twitch,
So, unfortunately, we got a bit of an audience that wasn't necessarily hitting that donation button so much, which was unfortunate. I mean, we had some of our usuals who have been all really awesome about... You know, supporting OSD, and you know, we'll be continuing throughout the month, being sure to pitch it. We have the bot. In fact, you people in chat right now, the bot will be dropping, I think, 10 to 15 minutes. It will drop the link if you haven't donated yet. Feel free to go check it out. Good cause. Yeah, helps out.
We actually
people
have
that are currently deployed.
Overlay right now too.
Oh, we do.
And the link is also, if you just want to click the link, it's below.
Scroll down,
Yeah, we put that in a few weeks
ago. Click all the links.
Click all the links. Just click them all and just figure it out. No, but yeah, seriously, you know, it's a group that helps soldiers currently deployed, people who are, you know, recouping due to injury, you know, a lot of our medical centers for veterans. Veterans are people, at least in my experience personally, this is all anecdotal, who don't ask for much. And in my opinion, they don't get necessarily what they deserve by a long shot. So,
yeah, I wholeheartedly agree with everything you just said there.
Yeah, so feel free to hit that link, drop some money in it. I don't know. I won't bring it up because we haven't discussed it yet. But I know Baron had been throwing some ideas around. But it's not developed enough.
Uh-huh.
We'll get there.
One day.
Yeah, but he'll be streaming after this, so after the show, check out Baron.
Exactly.
You do.
And I'm excited for our next event on the 31st as well, because we've pulled out all the stops. So we'll be streaming for OSD on May 31st, but we're doing an all-day event where all of RivalCast streamers are going to be on at various points during the day, so make sure to check that out. We should have a full schedule built by next week, and you'll be able to find more details about that at RivalCastMedia.com, so stay tuned. Indeed.
I look forward to that. You'll be finishing it off in style.
That's just how we roll around here.
It's just...
Classy.
Yeah.
Epic Worker in the chat explains some of this.
Oh, his statistics, it's pretty good.
Yeah, the source is his brain, but he says 50% of Twitch don't log in, and another 30 or so are just lurkers.
Says Seems Epic legit. Lurker. I mean...
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you've got people like me who've just got an addiction for sub buttons. I'm like, oh, you've got a sub button.
click.
I was literally telling myself the other day, I probably need to scale back. I've got, like, I think 18 subs. I was like, I probably should scroll back to 10. I added my 19th yesterday. I was like, never mind.
So
never mind
about
that.
So when you scale down, you and I both know that you're going to sub to Clara twice.
Yeah. I didn't realize I wasn't sub to Clara for the longest time. I was like, ooh, I should fix this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a little bit there. Just a little bit. Well, cool. Well, do we want to go to the Magic Hat?
We might as well.
We're very proud of the Magic Hat now.
I don't think I've ever experienced the Magic Hat.
Oh, you're in for a treat.
I think we had straight up questions, and then I think they pulled the pink box on you the last time that. Well, no, the last time you were here, Petra was with us, and we didn't even get through all the questions.
No, we just kept.
I think you got a pink box at one point, but this is the Magic Hat.
Stylish.
And the Magic Hat is full of random questions, so we don't know what will come out of the hat.
I have no idea.
And there
and some
is.
Of them told me I have to answer no matter what.
There actually are questions that have like stipulations that Bio has to answer them. There's also somewhere in here is a wild card
where
you get to answer. You get to ask us any question, and we all have to answer it. So, our first question of the night. Would you rather, and this is a choice thing, would you rather A, play the most politically correct video game imaginable, or B, never play video games ever again?
I know my answer. I'd have to go A.
Play the most politically correct video game imaginable. What's the most politically correct video game that you can imagine? It doesn't have to be a real one. I mean, just like, what would it be like?
He's trying not to get it.
It'd be like a mess of 1985 along with just, well, I don't know. I imagine a lot of beige.
Okay, I'll accept that answer.
Oh, there was a game that kind of made fun of this, actually. It was called, it was a parody game someone made called Walking Forward by Holding S or W or something like that in the rain. So it's like you're walking, everything's real beige, it's raining, you're walking, it's playing this really dull soundtrack.
I've heard of this!
Yeah, I have to find it again.
I think I've actually seen, because it...
You got achievements, just as you're
walking. Yeah, and like, you see the little trees on the side, and it's just, like, the only viewpoint is, like, you can see kind of, like, little bits of your arms as you're walking along. Is that the same one?
Okay, it's called Walking to Sad Pianos While Pressing W.
Yes.
I'll drop in the chat just for fun.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And scary at the same time.
I also, earlier this week, last week, discovered the least politically correct of all time, game of all time. It's a two-player game.
Yeah.
One person controls a baby, one person controls a dad.
Yes! We've played that!
Yes.
Who's your daddy?
Let me tell you. Baroness is an expert at getting to the bleach before Baron finds her. He's like, how'd you even find that? She's just like, nope,
how'd you get up from
bleach.
Upstairs?
No,
it wasn't even the bleach, it was eating batteries. I am a master at eating batteries.
Battery muncher champion.
Wow.
But he's very good at getting into the garage and setting himself on fire, so neither one of us is good at being the parent. We learned this. It was sad. It's very, very sad.
The stream I watched, I think the baby won every time. It was actually a streamer by the name of Strawberry Shortcake. She actually kicked off our event this month. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I was watching her play with one of her friends. It's just
amazing lemon cookies.
She does. I am hopefully one of these days get to try them.
I got to do the recipe the other day, and oh my god, I ate all of them.
All of them?
All of them.
All of the
all
cookies.
Of them. All of the cookies.
Now, Bubba is asking for clarification on this question. He said, could you only play the politically correct game?
Yes.
Or can you finish and get back to better games?
No.
So you're stuck.
Always,
just
you're
this
stuck.
One game? Or
yeah. For all eternity.
I'd have to. I would need a game.
Of some kind. Any kind.
If I played it for long enough, I'm sure I could find, like, glitches in it.
That is true.
Break the world.
That is true.
Suddenly, like, colors start appearing. Like, yes! It's working!
See, I don't know.
Look at that scene.
It'd be like The Matrix with Neo. Like, he's beginning to believe.
No. It'd be like 2001 in Space Odyssey, the movie.
Oh, no, yes! Just the zoom in on the face.
Yeah.
See, for me, I've lived without video games for a long time. And it's only recently that, you know, I've started to realize that they're fun. So I could live without them again.
Because I'm not
sure
I'd
want to
be more productive. I'm sure you'd have kind of a similar.
I'm actually going to say the same thing too. I mean, because the only time I really play games anymore is when I'm playing with RCM staff and crew and fans anymore.
Just because we're awesome.
Oh yeah, exactly. Because you guys actually know how to play games.
Well, I don't, but I'm at least fun with my ineptitude, so.
Well, also, you guys tolerate me when I go all crazy. God, goddamn, motherfucker, that should have worked! Let's go crazy when I'm doing poorly.
We send you cookies.
Exactly.
You feel better.
Speaking of, where are my cookies?
Oh, called out on air.
Well, do you remember the conversation we had about 3 minutes ago about Strawberry Shortcake's amazing lemon cookie recipe?
I said I ate them.
The idea was, because Baron doesn't eat lemon things, and I was like, oh, I'm never going to eat all these myself. I'll send half of them to Oklahoma. No.
And they're gone.
I should have made a double batch.
It's like the banking scene on South Park.
Hey,
and
Killer, where's the jerky? Where's
you
the
ate
jerky,
all my
Killer?
You ate all the cookies, I can't.
Like food ransom. Mexican stand-up with baked goods.
Just let you know, Sam, my jerky. What's to say?
It brings all the girls to the yard.
It really does.
My black jerky. Big, meaty black jerky.
Uh-huh. Well, if you want to send some to a friend of mine in Michigan, and then I can then. He is my go-to jerky expert.
Uh-oh. I'm here to challenge.
No, as it were. I like sharing my jerky, like letting people what their thoughts are, because, you know, I've been doing it for several years. I mean, I've been using the same recipe over and over again, so.
Secret family one too, right?
It's not really a secret family one. It's more of a one that we've been using a long time. My grandfather just used it. I think he got it from a hunting magazine a long, long time ago. So
lost in the bowels of time.
Yeah.
Did I ever tell you about the secret family recipe for pumpkin pie?
What you got from the devil?
All right, no.
By selling the family soul.
So
and playing the guitar better.
My grandmother makes these amazing pumpkin pies. I mean, just amazing pumpkin pies. And when I was growing up, it was like my favorite thing was like when she would make these pumpkin pies. So like Christmas and Thanksgiving and everything, she'd make tons of pies because we would just gobble them up. It was so good. And we would ask her, you know, Graham, you know, how, you know, what's your recipe for these pies? And she would look very knowingly and just nod and say, it's a secret family recipe. And she would never eat the pies because she hates pumpkin. She'll make pumpkin rolls and pumpkin pies and pumpkin bread. She'll make all of this stuff for anybody if they ask. And she loves baking for people. But she hates the taste of pumpkin, so she never eats any of it herself. She just gets this knowing look. It's like it's a secret family recipe. So finally, after years and years and years.
I guess on her deathbed.
No, she's alive and well. She's 80 years old. She's a very interesting old woman. But it was shortly after my grandfather died and she got on this like mortality kick. So finally she decided that she would break the secret.
What's the cipher, Rosebud?
After all those
it's
years.
It's a Betty Crocker. It's a Betty Crocker recipe,
no,
isn't it?
Close. Even worse.
She
it's
got
the
it with
recipe.
A Little Orphan Annie decoder ring.
It's the recipe off the back of the fucking Libby's pumpkin can.
Yes.
We're like,
bravo.
Wait a minute!
Bravo!
Amazing!
Oh, that's the best.
She was, we're like, but it doesn't. She's like, it's
imagine
all in
all
how
those
you
years,
think it.
She's been laughing at you behind
she
your
has.
Back.
She has. It was before I was born, as a matter of fact. Because her sister even, for decades, no idea. Ellen, how do you make this pie? Never tell anyone. Finally told me. I was like, Libby's. Really. Interesting.
Yeah. So.
Brilliant.
My dad uses an old Betty Crocker recipe to make our dough when he does pizzas. Or our calzones. Okay. His calzones, yeah.
Get mine from a book that's right over there.
I don't cook.
Don't feel
we
bad.
We just got killer into cooking. So.
Yes. No, yeah.
I barbecue. I can barbecue. That's
that's better than me.
Charcoal or propane? Or the
either or.
British
whatever. Whatever I've got to hand.
So I don't think we ever really clarified this the last time Hax was on. We asked this question because we got off on this side tangent about Hank Hill and things. Is it propane that you use for your gas grills in Britain, or is it like some other fuel? Because I know sometimes it's different.
I think as far as I know, it's propane. It's
okay.
Just flammable gas.
Okay.
I'm just curious.
Just curious, because the last time we got off on the side tangent about charcoal and propane.
The old C3H8.
We get off on sidetracks a lot, so, you know, it happens.
No. This is funny, because my girlfriend, we were having a discussion and everything, is like, you know what? You know who you are? You're Hank Hill. I was like, what are you talking about? I was like, hold on, what is it? I have to find it now. It's hilarious. It's like, perfectly disgusts me. Where is it?
But,
where is the
but you live in Texas's hat. I mean, it doesn't work that way.
Oh, apparently it does. Oh, there, wait, here it is. Think about it. He only has one kind of beer. His favorite food is steak. He enjoys keeping things simple. He has a limited group of friends, and he always says the wrong thing to women.
And his friends are kind of weird, so I mean, that actually does describe you very well.
Yeah.
There's a thing, there's a certain optimism with Hank Hill as well. Like, he walks around, he sees the world a certain way, and then when he doesn't see it, there's this moment. And then, you know, after that panic for a while, in some cases, he comes around and goes, you know, it's not too bad after all.
Yeah.
Killer's kind of like that, only instead of the bah, it's more of like a...
Pretty much, yeah. They make fun of me on that one, Sam. My sigh is well known.
It's notorious. I feel you.
We all have our quirks that people pick up on.
Yeah.
All right.
Uh-oh. What the hell?
Everyone's cameras disappeared.
Dum-dum-dum.
Damn you, Skype!
I think it just... Well, it says it's still going.
Well, the Skype call is, yeah.
Yeah, the call is still going.
Oh, there
we
go.
Have audio.
There it goes. It's coming back.
Oh, for a second, it's like, you need Skype Premium to make a group video call.
What?
Trying to go for that cash grab, I see.
Killer, they got, click your,
They got rid of that.
I don't know.
That's like...
There we go.
Yeah. Well, that was probably weird. I have an older version of Skype, so maybe that's what it is.
Wow.
Well, I'm like, they're, dark. Like, I have all of you guys,
indeed.
But there's like a... There's like a shade over us.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Ooh,
I've got that on my end as well.
Maybe we're turning down all the lights.
Well, we lost bio again for a second.
No, I was toggling to try and get rid of something, but it's not going away.
No, it's not going away.
It's all good. We're going to get after it. It's what we're going to do. No,
good.
Killer. Get after it.
Get after it.
Well, now that we have this dark shade over us, like the evil versions of ourselves, I guess.
Let's
go to the hat again. All right, our next question from the Magic Hat. All right, this one comes with the note at the bottom. Killer and Bio insisted on this question and said it would be easy, and it's dated 5/2/16. So it's we're normal.
Oh, the lights are back.
There we go.
Hey.
What's the best rivalry in gaming?
Ooh.
Yeah, I remember this one.
Me and Nintendo.
You and Nintendo? This sounds like a good story, Sam.
Yeah, continue.
I currently own like 70 amiibos, and mind you, they're about $20 ago.
Oh,
so
God.
Yeah, that's
a large sum of money I spent on just fucking amiibos.
Plastic, yeah.
And the Wii U, the DS, the games, but I don't know why I do it, because everything they do is bad right now. Like, they just don't listen to their fan base. Like, if you watch any of their E3 conferences or the Nintendo Directs, it's like, what we want from Nintendo is an open world, like, full island Pokemon game, like, and we want Pokemon Snap 2. Like, they're the two things that every Nintendo fan wants. It's like, okay, so we're going to give you Bejeweled with Pokemon skins on it. There you go. And it's just like, nobody wants this. And, like, they constantly push back the games that you want. Like, Star Fox, everyone was hyped for that. And then came out, it was just like, this looks the same as the N64 game. They didn't, like, make any...
Right. When they changed graphical. A few mechanics people liked, but they didn't... They were just like, well, it wasn't worth that kind of weight.
Yeah. And, like, I remember playing Mario Tennis, like, for hours on N64. And now they put it out on the Wii U, and it's just like, this game is super clunky, and...
Mm-hmm.
It just... And also, they don't like people playing their games for profit. Like, they don't like Twitch and YouTube. Like, you have to have specific licenses from them.
Right.
They're so backwards in their way of thinking. But I'm going to give them more money. Because I can't help it, because it's Nintendo.
You know, I had that kind of debate on there when the Wii U was first coming out as well, because I had a friend who had it. And he was holding the gamepad, the actual pad. And then when it came to, here's player two, oh, well, here's a Wiimote. I was just like, wait, so I don't get a gamepad?
No.
Like, no, only one works for console. And I just immediately said, why? Tell me from an engineering standpoint why Nintendo couldn't do that.
Yeah.
And money.
Pretty much. Well, but there's no way to do it at all. So it's not like you have to buy another in an expansion module. It's just, we're not going to do it. Really bizarre.
Bizarre.
Yep, because I had so many good ideas when I first saw that that design when they're first announcing it. It's like, oh, this is cool. They've got all these ideas that you could do, and oh well. So, what's your pick, Killer?
My pick would have to be all console fans versus all other console fans.
Okay, yeah,
the great
like
debate
Xbox versus PS4. Well,
no, even goes even before that. Nintendo versus Sega.
Sure.
Nintendo
versus
Sega versus Dreamcast.
Wars.
Yeah.
Tell me
PlayStation,
about it.
Yeah, all the consoles of all time.
And kids didn't know what bit meant, like between 8-bit console or 16-bit. They were just like, yeah, 16. That's more bits.
That's more.
That's
bits.
More numbers.
That's more
numbers. More numbers.
Yeah.
Because I think what was it? The Jaguar said 64. They were the first 64-bit. Console or something.
Yeah.
And people are just like, I don't know what it means, but it's
gonna
be better.
Yeah. I mean, I remember being a kid and that being important. It's like, oh, like when the Xbox first came out, it was important. Oh, Xbox. It's gonna destroy the competition, you know, so much better than all the other consoles, and realize like it's all about the games. Is the game any good?
Right.
Why can't we all just get along?
Pretty much.
Why can't we be friends?
So, we need to reach across the ocean and hold hands and just, yeah.
Oh, are we going to whip out the Ethernet cables like we were saying with Cassiopeia?
There we go.
Ethernet cord around the world for world peace. So, my answer for this is going to be artistic indie game fans versus AAA violent whatever fans. For some reason, they think that one side can't exist. And only my side is the right side. There was an article that just came out, and I forgot which website. I'm not even going to get into it on that part. Where it was basically like, my criticism of Doom 3 is justified, and therefore I'm on the right side of history. A game journalist said they were on the right side of history for hating this new Doom game. Because of, you know, it's very grotesque, you know, blood and gore, things explode, and there's red everywhere, and all that. And it's just like, but there's plenty of room in the world for Doom to exist and for whatever kind of more artistic, more story-driven or character-driven indie game.
By
both of them can
part.
Exist.
Yeah.
But each side is just intent on decimating each other. Like, oh, screw your your hipster games. Well, your Call of Duty stuff is disgusting and it shouldn't exist. You should be ashamed of yourself. And it's... Ah!
It's like... What's that? We all play games. Like, let's just focus on playing what we like.
Yeah.
Yeah, just... I mean... Ah. Not gonna get started on it. But yeah, it blows my mind. So I consider that one of the biggest rivalries currently.
Free your mind!
Yeah. Just... Yeah.
That game's gonna just, when that officially comes out, no other game stands a chance.
Yeah, Varyar's in chat going, violence solves everything, hippies. They started the war bio, we will finish it.
And, well, that's kind of true. A little true.
Yeah, Jack Thompson. No. So, Baroness, you have a gaming rivalry?
Not really.
Yeah,
I mean,
you do. You know which one you're talking about. The M game. Sims Baroness versus...
The Sims fans versus everyone else who is wrong.
No,
and then
she
counters every point I just made.
That was that time that I went slightly crazy when I was playing Farmville and became like that.
One time.
Crazy. I think you're so crazy.
I'm not proud of my actions during that time, but the fact that, and I think I've told this story on Tap before, but I had like spreadsheets that actually analyzed like every crop you could have in the game, and like what your cost and profit margins were, and then like they had forums where people could go and share their farming tips, and I felt the need to explain to them why they were wrong. So that's when I realized I had a problem.
What I'm hearing is we need to get Baroness into EVE Online.
Yeah. She could be our CEO. Yeah. We'll do all the work.
You would be
CEO. She'll
do
all the spreadsheets.
So EVE Online is like it's a space sim, massive multiplayer online game, but there's like a whole economy. There's diplomatic.
Oh, I would rule them. I would take over the entire game.
You could just start a corporation in there and just run the market side.
I actually
just bring
would
in the
moolah.
I don't. I have no doubt at all that
it wasn't even that was the problem. It was when I started like the intense mockery of others for not being because they would go on about like how great their systems were, and it was complete bunk. Like the math didn't even work out.
She was used to getting banned from game forums, apparently. She can't deny it. Look at her. She's just like, yeah, it's true.
And what were you about to say, Sam?
I was about to say, Crass Kitty, who streamed for us beginning of... She was our second streamer. She was actually top of our leaderboard until tonight. She's a huge EVE Online player. Like, Space Sims are her go-to. And she, like,
that's awesome.
Watching her play, I'm just like, I don't understand what buttons you're clicking or doing, but this is amazing. Like, she's a proper...
It sounds like we should join
forces.
Probably
likes her already. Yes, we need to. Varyar... And we actually talked about that at some point. We want to hook up with some of the OSD people a bit more, the streamer side. Gonna have to work on that.
Man, I've wanted to be friends with Strawberry Shortcake ever since the cookie recipe, to be perfectly honest. I was like, I want you on my recipe. Show now. We need to do this.
Indeed.
We can just bake cookies the whole time. I don't care.
I'm sure she'll be up for it. I'll give her a cool. Monday or Tuesday, maybe?
There you go. Cooking with Baroness and Shortcake live on Twitch.
And if we can get Andy LeQuinn from Xbox in, boom. We've got the three best chefs on Twitch right there.
I'm just saying, we could freaking rule the internet. We're starting the Empire. The Empire is starting right now. We're gonna do this. And we're going to figure out this EVE thing so that I can rule that too, and then...
Yeah. EVE is one of those games that I've tried to get into, and I just couldn't. However, whenever there's an article that comes out about just a gigantic battle, I'll just get absorbed in it. And for a while, there was a streamer that did kind of like an EVE Online news network, so they ran all the time. And then they would pop in to cover stuff that was going on in EVE. And when they would cover the huge battles, I'd just be going, holy crap, the amount of coordination this took. You know, for this one corporation to say, we're just going after this other corporation, it's wartime. Yep. Very impressive.
Yep.
Oh, don't even start, Varyar. Don't even.
Oh, I just realized one of my friends is in the chat. Shout out to Angel.
Hey, hello. Angel.
Hello.
I think she's supporting I Like Garbages. He looks pretty ugly comment because she likes any burns towards me. She'll instigate and she'll follow through with.
Terrible.
Oh, yes, Bubba. You are definitely going to be on my board of directors. They have boards of directors, right? Well, they will shortly.
Make one?
They will shortly. Bubba says, I fear for EVE Online's population. When I join, they'll spend all their money on useless shit. That's exactly what we want, Bubba. That's why you're now my director of marketing.
The next question?
Next question.
Further down the rabbit hole we go.
Yep. What will we be?
Indeed.
By the way, Bio.
Still carrying it wrong. Just saying.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. So I had this dream last night where the entire dream was that I was chasing this rabbit around because I was trying to catch it, but I didn't want to just grab it. I was trying to scoop it from underneath like you showed
me. Yes!
And that was the entire thing. And I woke up this morning going, God. God.
Never caught it.
I didn't. I didn't either. It was horrible.
Hit the one I used to have, I think it just loved to trick people. It would make a fool out of anybody in the family, just being like, nope, I don't feel like being grabbed today.
I'm now getting like horror flashbacks from playing Super Mario 64, and there was when in that game there was like random bunnies would appear in the sort of holding zone that you'd have to chase and you'd have to dive to pick up. And like I think it happened 3-4 times throughout the game, and the final one just kept on evading me. Like every time I thought I had it cornered, boom. It would just outshoot me, so.
Rabbits are tricky little creatures, I'm just saying. Alright, so the question is, this is actually a really good one. If you were to redesign the Mount Rushmore of video game characters, what four faces would make it on your sculpture?
Oof. Yeah, that's going to be a toughie.
But like part of me wants to say like your Sonics, your Marios.
Yeah, well, definitely Mario has to be definitely one of them. I think we all can agree on that one.
But I think Sonic has to come before Mario.
Okay.
Really? What?
Yeah.
Defend your position, sir.
It's Sonic. He was a better character. Sure, Sega didn't have the longevity of Nintendo. So I think my bitterness for Nintendo is shining through right now.
I can think of three right off the bat, and I'm not sure who I would pick for my fourth one, though. So
I would say.
Which question is this again? Sorry, I was managing something on.
Which what four video game characters would you have be a Rushmore for video games?
Gotcha.
So my three right off the bat, in no particular order, would be Mario.
Yeah.
Master Chief from Halo.
Yeah.
And the llama. From The Sims.
What?
Really?
Because no,
this
seriously.
Is the hill you're going to die on, Baroness?
Apparently, she
because
is.
In The Sims, like, all the characters look different, but the one thing that The Sims will always come back to in conversations, and I don't know why, but, you know, it's just a running thing, is they will always come back to talking about that llama. So the llama from The Sims needs to be on that Mount Rushmore of gaming.
I do believe I'm going to have to use my pseudo-doctor status to order a CT exam, because you must be out of your mind.
Oh, well, who would you put on yours? I'm still
so
trying to
Pac-Man
think of who
for
I'd
sure.
have fourth.
I'm kind of going in order. So Pac-Man, I'd put Mario, I would definitely put Sonic, and then I'd probably agree with Master Chief as the fourth. Just because it's a more modern character, the other option I would put would be possibly Solid Snake. Solid Snake's cross multiple... multiple consoles over the years. Alternative.
I will have to throw somebody from Borderlands in there. Potentially Moxie.
Yeah. I'd be down with that. In fact, I'm going to change one thing. I'm going to go with Mrs. Pac-Man because that was the arcade game that was played more. People had a lot more fun, so it would make sense to have Ms. Pac-Man instead.
Yeah.
In terms of playability.
Yeah.
Or which just would just be four Pac-Man pigeons from Hatterful Boyfriend and confuse the word.
Happens.
Sub-Zero is a really good shout.
Indeed.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, no.
Morgan Freeman. Always Morgan Freeman, yes.
Always Morgan Freeman.
So Sandra had to narrate all those games.
Exactly.
Steve from Minecraft would be a good one, too. Oh, and Garayan is correcting you. It's Ms. Pac-Man bio.
Ms. Pac-Man, that's what I said.
Ms.
No, it's no, not Ms. MS is Miss.
What?
Moving on. My answer, God, that's going to be tough. I would think instead of, I was originally thinking like one character from each console or platform, but then there wouldn't be enough room for all the consoles and on
PC. And there's some cross-play, at least with Sonic now.
Yeah. So I'm thinking more of like genre-defining characters, or like maybe like the very forefathers of the genre. So Mario would be like the platformer.
Like E.T. for the Atari.
No. No, genres. Genres, sir. Genres.
I think that deserved to be its own genre.
Epic failure.
Terrible video game.
No, see, that's at the base of the mountain. See,
okay, this is like, so it'd be yeah, at the bottom. Just the shape.
I definitely would have to say Mario would have to be number one as the platformer. I would love to say Halo, but it can't be. It has to go all the way back to Doom. To me, it has to go back to the Doom Marine.
Okay.
Doom has the history, but does the Doom lead character...
No. See, to me, it's not so much about the character. It's about defining it. It was the forefather of the first-person shooter genre in my head.
Yeah. Okay. I'm feeling you.
Yeah, they're more representative of the genres themselves than actual characters. I mean, kind of contrary to you guys.
Okay.
Let's see. Ryu from Street Fighter.
Okay.
I'll go with Ken, but okay.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see. One more.
Just so you know, Chun-Li killer, so sexist. Look at that man. That's a man who just caught in a PC trap.
Damn you.
So many choices, though.
I know. Did it again.
The thing happened again.
That is weird.
So oh, wait, I just thought of this way to do this. Just awful characters from Battletoads.
Oh, there you go. I like...
We covered everything. We've got performing, we've got amazing. Punching people.
Mm-hmm. I need one for a strategy game, and I can't think of a strategy. Kane. We're going to do Kane from Command & Conquer.
I was going to say something Blizzard, maybe.
Gotcha.
I would say Command & Conquer, though.
I just feel like Blizzard would need some sort of representation in this.
Yeah, I'll give you that. I could give you a toss-up between a Blizzard character versus a Command & Conquer character.
Sure.
So, but...
Yeah, I have like a...
But to me, Command & Conquer is more dear to my heart.
So many good characters, though. When you hit Blizzard, I mean...
Yeah, there's a lot.
Their track record. A lot of good characters.
Very much.
Chat's really getting into this question.
Yeah, so Sayonara is saying Dr. Mario, Thrall, so Blizzard character there, Master Chief, and Samus. And Samus
would be a good one.
I definitely agree there.
Yeah. There's too many good characters.
Yeah. It needs to be more like a video game Hall of Fame.
Pretty much.
Which does exist.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I was about to say, I was going to...
We need to do that. Oh, there's our light again. Huzzah! There we go. We need
didn't
to
pay
do
our
that.
Budget.
Praise be the sun.
Can I ask an alternative version to that question?
Sure.
Instead of video game characters, the four video game developers or real-life industry people.
Okay, so Cliffy B for sure.
Cliffy B, always number one. Dima. I think would have to be in there. Miyamoto, definitely Miyamoto, and then Gaben.
Yeah, Gaben, yeah.
Gaben is the mountain upon which all of them
are gone. especially with, oh my god. It's going to be a... You know what's going to be funny? You know what they're going to do? This is how they're going to screw with us. The day Gaben dies is when they announce Half-Life 3. They're not even going to announce it. They're just going to release it.
Yeah, like, just drop it.
It's actually, yeah. It's been ready for years, and they just won't.
Waiting for him to die.
It'd be even better, though, if they made it where it was only available to one randomly chosen Steam user, and it was somebody who hasn't used Steam in years.
They'll send it to me!
No, it would not be Baroness. Oh, that'd be funny, because she'd be like, what's this Half-Life 3 thing that's on here? I don't remember buying this. And everybody would freak out.
I'm like that every time something shows up in my library.
Yeah.
See, I'm like, well, I'm gonna play The Sims now.
Pretty much.
Baron's like,
no. Sim, okay, first of all, Sims is an Origin, not in Steam. But anyway,
very true.
Can't you imagine a very
You have to open up your freaking Origins thing every damn time, and by open, I mean hit update 4 times, and then you can open.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Very true. It's very true.
I'm actually, speaking of Steam, I'm very lucky in the fact that I won a code for the Steam Family and Friends Pack.
So oh, nice.
Any game Steam have ever made and ever will make, I get for free. Eventually, when Half-Life 3 comes out,
yes.
It will be in my library.
Who'd you... All right, either you knew...
He won it.
He won it, huh?
I did. It was Alienware, the people who stream from the Alienware Twitch account. When they first started, I actually know the person who was setting up the stream, so the first couple of Alienware streams didn't have that much traction before people realized, oh, wait, Alienware's live. And they're doing giveaways. And I'm like, hey, I'm one of the few people in here. Thank you.
You know where the bodies are buried, don't you?
Yeah.
That's what it is. There's some dark, deep secret you know.
And in fact, Angel won that exact same code as well, I believe.
Fantastic. Yeah. She said I did too.
I don't trust being Alienware nerds.
Nerd!
Fantastic. No. Oh, I'll have you know, Baroness, Velvet Dove just said Steam now has Sims 3.
Do they? Damn it, well, I'm not going to re... Actually, you know what? The more I think about it, I might rebuy it just because I forget.
Wow.
Yeah, pretty much.
That is sad.
Like, I'll go back to Sims 3 instead of... Because we're on Sims 4 right now. And
That's what I thought. So Troggle says it's been on there for a while. I thought the same thing.
Well, they were on 4, though.
No.
So... When I had Sims 3, it wasn't on Steam. It was on the discs.
Mm. So. Oh, there's at the Mountains of Madness.
Let's see. I would have to go with...
Bubba's saying, spend $500 to get the Sims on Steam. You think I won't, Bubba? You think I won't?
Oh, Bubba.
All right. I think we have time for one more question.
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
All right. Who were the top 3 funniest game characters you've come across?
Ooh.
Yeah, this one I wasn't sure about when we added it to the pile.
Well, I know one
there
of
was,
my.
What's his name? Johnny from Metal Gear Solid series. They finally did some really funny stuff with him in 4.
Mm.
Where it turned, like, he always seems really uncoordinated and clumsy compared to the other team members, and it turns out it's because he doesn't like, he's afraid of shots. He didn't get the nanomachine injection, so he wasn't, you know, synced with everybody else on the team.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know
he was
one
kind of comic relief during that game.
One of my top 3, right off the top of my head, would be Mr. Torg from Borderlands.
Yeah, that was gonna be mine.
Which, honestly, it like with my gaming experience again, a lot of the games I experience, it's watching other people play before I started playing, and the reason I was even watching Borderlands in the first place was because of his character, which I thought was really cool because he's actually one of the voice actors who will be on our discussion panel at RivalCon in 6 weeks.
Nice.
So, yeah, Chris Rager is the actor that plays Mr. Twerk, and I think the character's absolutely hysterical. I mean, absolutely hysterical.
Also, and it was, Hercule, aka Mr. Satan on Dragon Ball.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
I'm just saying. So I had a phone conversation with him earlier in the week when we were talking about this panel, and it was exceptionally difficult for me not to, like, because you're having this conversation, you know the voice, and it was so hard not to break into the middle of our conversation with, like, explosions or badassery, or just a random guitar solo.
D is going to want him to record something for him. Probably. Sure. Like, please do this clip.
So.
I actually found Damien Baird from Gears of War quite funny, like his very sarcastic nature. Mm-hmm. I think I was... I don't think so. There's somebody in Fable.
Fable was a fantastic game.
I know. I'm so sad that it's all dead and buried.
All for naught.
I'm gonna go from Garrus from the Mass Effect series. It's kind of like that your battle buddy, and you guys are just he's kind of like the straight man, and like mm-hmm. the two man comedy routine. He's like, oh yeah, blah blah blah, just pointing out the obvious. I was gonna go with Mr. Torg too, but I, you know what? I'll have to switch my answer to Tiny Tina.
Wheatley from Portal 2 because.
He's pretty good
as well.
Wheatley is fantastic.
Baroness, have you started Portal 2 yet?
I haven't played single player yet.
Okay, single player is a hilarious opening, especially the way they kind of do the tutorial for the keys. Mm-hmm. It's humorous. You've got to try it.
Well, I'm
spin it up tonight, not even to start the game, just to get to the tutorial part.
Okay.
It's fun. It's worth it.
Well, actually, that'll be my third, Mr. Wheatley. Yeah, Wheatley. Yeah. So many good characters.
Oh, there are. I'm just trying to nail it down.
It's so hard.
Yeah, Cave Johnson, if you're going to go with Wheatley as well.
Yeah.
Just a character Cave who's Johnson. Not, you never, you know, run into.
You'll never interact with.
No,
yeah,
but that right. He is still, he's still ever a very present. Fantastic character.
I have his portrait in my house. It's the talking frame, yeah.
Very nice.
Is it mounted? Is it a mounted? Oh no, killer! It needs to be above your fireplace. It needs to be mounted there.
It's itty bitty, so it wouldn't look right. All right, well, if it was bigger, yeah.
We need to get you like one of those gilded framed like portrait size ones to put over your fireplace, and then
no.
Do we get the creamer? Image to go next to it.
No. Actually.
No, I'm just picturing Killer in like this, like smoking jacket, like sipping his scotch as he leans on the mantle, and you know, Cave Johnson's portrait's right behind him.
Like tossing a lemon.
No. Actually,
gone into his cookies if you'd sent them.
They were so good. I couldn't help myself.
No. Actually, I joked with my parents that, you know, maybe I should do one of those 19th century paintings where, you know, the men are in military uniforms with all the flourishes and everything, and have an actual family portrait where all the men, you know, me, my brother, my dad were in the military uniforms and my mother in a 19th century, fancy dress.
I can picture that, actually, and I think it looks amazing.
It would, but he's like, no, you can't do that. It's like, oh, come on!
Sure they can.
It'd be expensive to get someone to do it, though.
Wouldn't.
Well, yeah, it would. To get someone who can do it right, yeah.
That would be amazing.
Killer, it sounds like you need a decentralized command.
I think I do.
Just take over. Oh, so, Seo was asking what the deadline for signing up for RivalCon is.
Like right now, you have 5 minutes. 5 minutes.
Baron said, "Don't take our time, no hurry." He may still be looking for a game. I think.
He's
been on this kick since it's Friday the 13th, and you know how he gets on Friday the 13th. He wants it to
crazy.
Be perfect. So he's trying to pick out the perfect game.
So he's going to play Atari Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I don't know.
It's possible. So to answer Seo's question, though, so the RivalCon tickets, I think I have open until like a week before the event. So you still have time if you need to purchase them. What I would ask, though, is if you're planning to get your RivalCon tickets and you haven't placed your order yet, but you know you're going to, I do need to get the order for t-shirts in this weekend. So please email me with your t-shirt sizes and just let me know, you know, about when you're planning to get your tickets so I can get and make sure that we have the right sizes of t-shirts for everybody. You do still have time to get your tickets, but if you're planning on being there, just let me know what your t-shirt size is so I can make sure that I order it.
Extra awesome.
I already got your size, Killer, so we're good.
Oh, that's right, triple awesome.
Yep. So, all right.
Next question.
Yeah, since we're stalling for Baron.
Actually, Baron said he's already got a game. He's just saying, hey, have more fun. So.
Oh, okay.
Oh, well.
That's understandable.
I think...
said right now.
I get... We're not even going to put up the end screen. That we're just going to hit the button. we'll leave it up to our guest, our patient for the evening, and see if he wants one more question for the...
One more question, yeah. I think
one more question for the road.
And... Yes.
Excellent.
Send him to sleep. All right. Oh, Lord. What's the last time you did something mean to someone? Baron says I do this all the time.
You do it to him.
I slapped him and told him to shut his mouth.
like, bitch! Well, who told you to talk?
Oh, while you do that, we did have two donations that have come through. I think
excellent.
One of them has actually been there for a bit, but... Pat the Badger has donated, and Lysert donated.
Thank you, Lysert.
Thank you both.
Yes, thank you both. The soldiers, thank you.
Hi, thank you. All of Operations Supply Drop, thank you.
I think they'll be curious who Pat the Badger is, perhaps.
Yeah. That's okay.
And, you know, is Pat the Badger a honey badger? We don't know. We don't.
Maybe they don't care.
We can hunt.
Yeah, maybe they don't care.
I think I posted them online, but the Olive had actually made some really, really cool cover art for... It was minimalist cover art, but it was really well done for Pat the Badger. And what was the other one? It's escaping my mind right now, but Velvet had done another one on their Sim stream, and he did cover art for both of them, and it was fantastic. So, but back to the question. I don't know. I try really hard not to be mean to people, at least intentionally.
The same way. I think
in their time, she drops draconian policies.
Exactly.
Hey, most of the time I'm fighting against draconian policies, so...
Not according to whoever it was who said that.
Although Bubba says making people spend money on useless shit considered mean. Not really, just very trollish. Very trollish.
I'm just saying, you're a director of marketing. I mean, that's sort of your job. You're just doing what you're supposed to do.
I'm really struggling for something.
I am too. Oh, wait, you got something?
Well, you guys can decide if it's mean or not.
Okay.
So I was on the London Underground, very compact, a lot of people. Old lady walks in, I step up to give her my seat, she declines. I go to sit back into it, and this other kid has sat in the seat. So I was like, okay, that's different. I literally stood up to give my seat to somebody who I thought would need it more than me. She didn't want it, so you're going to take it. Cool. We just so happened to be getting off at the same stop, and like he barges past me, like literally he walks through, like knocks me to the side to go to the door. I'm like, I was already walking to the door to get out. I'm like, okay,
right.
And then you pushed him into the gap, didn't you? Tell me you pushed him into the gap.
I don't let him finish.
And so I was like, okay, this dude must be in a rush to go somewhere if he's barging past. And we get onto the platform, and he's walking the slowest I've ever seen a human walk in front of me. And that's where I had enough, so I kicked him in the back of the ankles and pushed him into a wall so he fell over and stepped over him. I'd had enough. I was like, you've hit me off three times now. I don't know you, but I'm really not in the mood for this.
That's amazing.
And he's like looking around him like, who did that? And I was just like, gone. See ya. Yeah, that's the last mean thing that I can think of that I've done.
Something in my head wants me to put like Sam's head on top of Assassin's Creed cover. Something like that. Except instead of murdering, it's like kicking him into a wall and then fade off into the crowd. Like, who did that? Like a bunch of monks come by and he just like hides among them.
I generally don't do mean things. I was trying to find a positive and easy solution.
Sure.
And if I do upset someone, it's due to a mistake that I've, like, an oversight. Like, I upset a friend recently by joining their game whilst they were streaming, because they'd never played the game before. Mm. I'd played it, and I knew that there's a dancing emote. So my plan was to dance around the corner, but it kind of messed up their game a bit by me joining. And that was just a mistake on my part. That wasn't something I didn't intentionally mean to be mean. It wasn't, I'm going to mark up the game. So, this will be funny. I fucked up the game.
Just a mean person, Sam. Just a mean.
I'm kind of that way about some streamers that don't want. So I can understand if a streamer doesn't want help, like they don't want someone telling you how to play the game, because micromanagement in chat is a pet peeve.
Yeah.
I don't even like seeing it, and I don't even stream on this channel all that much. Haven't in a long time, at least. But there are some people where, like, they'll have moderators who just, like, anything that looks like a spoiler, they'll just, like, time you out. And that kind of bugs me. I've not done anything about it, but I've had in my head times where I just wanted to make another account and pop up and just ruin the game when a mod does that. Just to be like, because there's a certain degree where I could understand, for sure. You know, you don't want to tell a plot point or how to solve a puzzle, because that takes some of the fun out of it.
Yeah, it does.
Both people watching and the person playing. But then when it's something where it's like, how's that even a spoiler? Like, I just said what the person said on stream to themselves to remember it. So I put it in chat so they could just look and remember it. Because they asked, you know, I'm going to have to... It's the same thing as writing things down, in my head at least. And you have to kind of tiptoe in some of those stream channels.
Yeah.
I've wanted to. I've never done it, though. It's like, I'm not going to be a douche. I'm fine with just my one Twitch account that I intend to not get banned from anything on.
Yeah.
Play nice.
I'll be honest. So in my day job, I'm responsible for, you know, a lot of different things. And I have been known on occasion to, when somebody has a request, but they're like nasty about it. If it's something that, you know, isn't like it has to be done right now or it'll get screwed up. Like if it's something that realistically could wait, but they're just, you know, being pushy about it, I have been known on occasion to just let them sweat it out for a little bit longer than
necessary.
Longer than necessary. It's not that I don't have time to do the thing. It's just they're being kind of dickish about it. And so my thought is, if they waited, you know, because they can do these things on their own, they've waited past the time that they knew that, you know, they could do it, and then are demanding that they get
put, be done in some,
that
yeah.
it be done, which means that I have to do it. My thought is, as long as it's not like, if I wait, it'll screw this person over. I mean, obviously I wouldn't do that.
Right.
But
don't lie.
But let them sweat it out.
I'd think about it. Basically. Yeah, let them sweat it out a little bit and not respond to their emails. Because I'm known for being good about, like, if somebody messages me about something, I'll at least give them some sort of response, like, hey, you know, okay, sure. I can
it's
have this
queue,
done. You know,
whatever.
It's, and, yeah, exactly. I
unless
saw
it's me
it,
emailing you.
Well, that's only
so
because
that's
I was responding.
This one time, there's a guy named Sam from some organization. I totally didn't reply to his emails. Just like, whatever.
Like 3 months. 3 months.
No, well, it was more like 3 weeks, I think. And I was waiting for a response back, and it was just because I sent it from my phone, and so you were hitting the, then it wasn't
right.
the thing. But
I just thought of a mean thing I've done. I actually got into, so I've said it before, I don't know if Sam was here, but I worked in a pediatric hospital in IT years and years ago. I don't know. And there was a doctor, resident doctor.
He was banned.
Close. No, he was probably a second or third year, perhaps. Probably a second year resident, which just means he's been out of med school. He's now in his first couple years of practicing. Not an intern, but still not on their
own. Full-fledged, yeah.
Yeah, they're still accountable to someone. And they're learning. So, and we got all the pediatric ones who do that. And this one guy just thought he was on top of the world and was really snide to my phone support person. And I pretty much called him back and just said, you know what? I see your ticket. I'm not doing it until you apologize. Just like you're a doctor. You're a professional. You know, I make just about as much as you. You're nothing. There are plenty of other residents around here. And, you know, when you decide to be a professional doctor, then I'll fix your ticket. And because, you know, it had upset. And this particular person, she was really good about, she'd laugh at stuff. And she's worked with some of the old grouchy doctors before. So she can, she's pretty thick skinned. And that one just really annoyed the crap out of her. The way he spoke down to her and was just like, I'm a doctor and you're not. And, you know, this thing isn't working and you're going to fix it in whatever time. It's just like, dude, no. It's like, you've talked to the wrong person. I've told, you know, surgeons that they can go scream at the server because it's not going to fix itself. It's going to take time.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's probably the meanest thing I've done recently. Was pretty much tell a doctor they were kind of a nothing and I wasn't going to help them. I felt they deserved it, but it's probably a little
mean. Yeah, that's like an that's education for them more than it wasn't mean. It was the.
And he admitted he was having a bad day when he apologized and all that stuff, and he was fine after that, but it was just that one moment of, look, I understand you have a rough time, you know, everybody in healthcare does, we try and be understanding, but you crossed the line, buddy.
Yeah. Apologize.
Yeah, apologize.
Is it? No. Oh, fuck, no. Kiss the ass, no.
Anyway, I only saw the first 10 seasons of South Park. I don't remember.
It's been a while. It was the Jesse Jackson episode where one of the characters said, you know, the N-word on national television. And he has to go apologize, and Jesse Jackson bends over. He's like, kiss it. Apologize.
Right. Well,
It's Stan Marsh. Randy Marsh.
Randy Marsh, yeah. Yeah, that one. Yeah.
It's meant to say naggers.
Yeah.
Well, making fun of the way everybody always goes to the same two people when someone makes a racist gaffe. It's just like, why don't you just apologize to, you know, everybody? You don't have to go to this one person and kiss their
ring. They don't represent all, you know, all, yeah.
Right. Just like, just own up to it. Extreme ownership.
Exactly. And I'm trying to remember the meanest last time I was mean on purpose.
I'm trying to, like, picture you being mean to anybody.
Yeah, I just
ever.
Wondered, like, what would drive Killer to the point where he's just like, I'm going to format this guy's hard drive. Check this out.
I mean, I've actually been with you in situations where other people have done, like, ridiculously, like, not just retarded things, but, like, dangerously retarded things, where you were, like, actually... And you wouldn't even lose your cool then. You were, like, shaking a little bit, like... But even then, you were just completely polite.
What was that?
When we were getting stuff for New Year's and people were cutting us off left and right and you were just like,
oh, I was thinking about when he did tech support for you one time.
Oh God!
And I sent him the video. Okay, Baroness, we're gonna rip on you just a hair. I sent I sent Killer a funny video from SpongeBob SquarePants. Where Patrick was showing Squidward how to hold the net to go jellyfishing. And it's just like, and it's not Squidward's fault. He's bandaged up, so he can't reach. And he's just like, firmly grasp it with your hands. And he just drops it, and it bounces off the cast. And he picks it up again, firmly grasp it. Bounces again. Finally, he just grabs it, shoves it through his hand, and goes, firmly grasp it!
Are you crying, Killer? Oh my god!
I just saw you... killer once. I forgot what it was. It's something where you like you weren't seeing what he was seeing. You're just there, killer.
I think I was trying to walk her through how to edit one of our videos to put on YouTube.
Yeah, that's what it was. And you guys weren't seeing the same thing. So I said that.
I was just trying to. I'll admit, most of the time it's me not being very clear in my instructions. I will own up to that, because in my head it's this and this. When for you it's
the first time you're seeing the user interface. Period. Which is a whole new. It's just like, but I want to press this one thing. Well, no, you go to this menu. But it makes sense to press this one thing.
No, don't go there.
No.
Don't go there. No, I'll probably say this. I can be mean when I'm driving my car on the I've been told I do cut people off, which I probably have done without being intentionally doing it, just because, god damn it, go fast. So yeah, it's probably screw you, Bubba. I'm not gonna.
What's
snap
Bubba one. Doing?
You think it's I'm gonna snap one day? That's why he's afraid of me.
We've actually had that discussion while you weren't around.
You know what's sad?
Like, what you would be like if you actually went off the deep end, because you are, by far, of every person on staff at RivalCast, you are the most even-tempered person that we have, consistently. And, yeah, that would be the most terrifying thing, I think, ever.
You're just saying that because I own a lot of firearms. That's what you're just saying.
Well, it's not. Well, that's part of it. I'm not going to lie. That was part of the conversation. But
I didn't even put that into account.
It's, don't lie you by know, you did.
I figured that you would just wipe everyone's hard drives on the base one day. Just be like, nope, I'm done. Magnets. Just throw them.
Actually, I wouldn't even do that. What I'd probably do is I'd take them all out. And just start smashing the with a sledgehammer.
There you go. No, because it'd be your last day. Well, you're snap anyway, so who cares?
Yeah, I'm walking off the base.
Yeah, you take all the hard drives and just swap them into different computers so nothing boots, and they don't know which hard drive goes into which PC.
Oh, that'd be evil.
That is pretty evil.
You'd have to make sure that the hardware spec was different enough, though.
This is what I would do.
Uh-oh.
This is what I would do.
Should I end the
OJ
show
moment.
Now?
I didn't this know that if this actually happens
later, then, you know, this can't be used against you in court. Should I hit the button?
If I could somehow go to the head of every single agency department on the base, all the way from the actually commanding general to all the department
on the edge
heads.
Of my seat here.
I would steal all their hard drives. Yeah, hold them ransom.
I just want it known to our government overlords that I had no part in this particular plot that went through Killer's mind.
I'm not saying
this is a CNN news alert.
And actually, I don't think I could get away with it. I don't think I could do it. I wouldn't have the resources to pull it off. Because there'd be so many, they're in so many different buildings, and getting access to said building would be a pain.
But just saying, you know.
What might be an easier solution is find the main server room and just turn the air conditioning off. Just turn it up to warm, fry everything.
Actually, I know where a lot of the servers are,
Don't be admitting to this, killer. This is bad for you. Something bad is going to happen, and then this episode is going to be used against you.
Yeah,
and the scary thing is, it's not even going to be a civilian court. It's going to be like a military tribunal, and I don't know if I can get you out of that.
No, I admit it. I'd own up to it. Extreme ownership.
Yeah, I did it.
Damn right, I did not do it again.
Do it again.
Because you need me on that wall. You want me on that wall.
I'm a little scared now.
Amazing.
I don't want to question the man who gives you your freedom. I just want you to give me, like, thank you. Let me do my job.
When I first started working at the hospital, especially during the summer, We actually had to, like, bring in fans in the server room because they didn't have the water cooling system put in. It had been on the budget for a while, but had not been approved for capital spending, so...
Yeah,
and this one particular time, it hit a certain point where servers just started turning off. Because it, you know, it hit the maximum point on the board.
And they would shut off, yeah.
Yeah. So there was no warning whatsoever, and we were on the other side of campus at this point, because they'd moved us, which we thought was a dumb idea, because we're away from the servers. And sure
It made sense to some bureaucrat.
It made sense to somebody who was trying to make some doctors happy, who wanted their endocrinology department to have our office space. And just like, okay, whatever, cool.
Money, yeah.
But then things just started turning off. And you just, like, hear the server guys over in their area, like, whoa, just running around. It was great.
Yep.
Oh.
Everyone says I'm going to disappear now. Go to Gitmo. Only problem is they're going to close it down, so.
Yeah, no problem there. Checkmate, got to find a new facility, sir.
At least we knew where Gitmo was. We might have been able to rescue him, but, you know.
That would be amazing. I could just
maybe
see
Maybe we'll move him to Okinawa, because I'd totally go to rescue him. I'd probably get lost in progress. He'd be like, so many beautiful Japanese women.
No. See, what,
supposed to rescue someone.
No, this would be like the plans. Like, Fire, we'd scrambling like this Ocean Eleven's plan, and Bio, I need you to infiltrate the base doing this. It's like, okay, I got it. Next thing, there'd be a scene of this Bio sitting in the office with all these Asian women, just talking to them.
And just be like, fixing their computer. I'm supposed to do something, aren't I? Like, I can wait.
When are we crowdfunding the RivalCast movie and making this happen?
I keep telling them that's going to be our next logical step because, you know.
Oh, dear.
I'm just saying, book 3 is going to be amazing. Amazing!
It'll be huge.
Oh, you have no idea.
Huge.
You have, like, your mind is going to be so blown, killer. I'm excited about it.
I think on that note, we probably should wrap it up. I think Sam's about
probably
to fall
should,
asleep.
Probably should, yeah. Sam is implicated in any more... Yeah.
Just before I put my visa application in, let's just hope this nobody sees this part of the episode.
Yes, I sincerely hope you have a much easier time than Total Biscuit did with his visa stuff.
Find out. This year we'll
know.
One way or another.
I think he had something where he was on a list for some reason, and like no one could tell him why, so a lot of it was bureaucracy trying to get off said list.
I'm not here
to blow you up. My wife lives there. I want to move there.
Because someone didn't like what he said.
Yeah, someone at EA got so butthurt.
Exactly. We're going to screw that guy over.
Yeah. Put him on a couple of watch lists.
Would not be surprised.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, Sam, for hanging out with us, and we hope you feel better soon.
Thank you for having me, and my doctors have made me feel better. I'm sure I'll make a full recovery.
Excellent.
Sure.
If you don't blame us and sue us.
We don't know what suing is over here.
That is true.
I know, it's so beautiful. All right, Baron's up next, so stay tuned for that. Again, don't forget, we have our the 8-Bit Salute will be going on throughout the end of the month. We will be back on for a very special all-day stream in support of Operation Supply Drop on the 31st, so stay tuned to RivalCastMedia.com for additional details on that. And from all of us here at RivalCast Media, cheers!